I'm Jimmy Chang. I've been teaching college math for almost a decade, and we're here to talk about what's involved in calculating a CD, or certificate of deposit, as they say. And actually, the centerpiece of that is in this particular formula that we're going to talk about very shortly, and as you can see over here. Now, it does look a little bit involved, but I can explain to you what some of these things actually mean. Now, there's a lot of letters that you see there. A equals P times 1 plus R over 365, all that to the nth power. Woohoo! Lots of different things there. But if we break it down little by little, here's what they mean. Now, the A stands for amount. Amount is pretty much how much you have at the very end, otherwise known as ending balance. P stands for the principal. That's how much you're depositing in terms of the amount of the CD. R, which is located in the numerator over here, is the interest rate. Now, 365, you might recognize that, of course, as the number of days in a year. That is because interest is compounded, generated on a daily basis. Okay? And N is the number of days that you want to keep the CD. As you know, CDs have a lot of different rates, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 5 years, however long you want to take. But N is the number of days that you want to keep the CD. So if you know you want to keep the CD for 6 months, that's about 180 days, and that's the number that you would plug in into your calculator when you want to find out the amount. And when you plug in all the numbers that you already know back in here, you will figure out after how many days how much your CD is worth. So, I'm Jimmy Chang, and that is how to calculate the value of a certificate of deposit.